So now that we know what ILP is, let's look at an example of computing the ILP just so that we can be on the same page about that. First, we need a program. So let's say we have this program. We have already renamed it so that only the true dependencies remain. So now let's look for those true dependencies. We write to P10. This instruction doesn't use P10. Actually, the first one that uses P10 is this one. We write to P6. Nothing uses P6. We write to P5. This one uses P5, so there is a dependence basically here, and another one here, and then here we produce P4. So we only have really these two true dependencies. So now let's look at like what can execute in which cycle. To do that, the best way is to just kind of check off instructions and counter cycles. So in the first cycle, we can do this, 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 and this, because none of these instructions has any incoming dependencies yet. In the second cycle, okay, this one cannot be done in the first cycle because it has a dependence from this and this, and that's not been done in the first cycle yet. So after the first cycle, all of these are done. So now we can do this. So what we get is now the ILP is equal to how many instructions? 5 over how many cycles? 2. We got an ILP of 2.5. Again, we didn't need to know what the processor looks like. Now some convenient tricks for computing the ILP. First, I didn't actually need to rename the program. If this program had real registers with some anti and output dependencies, I could just fake renaming, but just looking at where the true dependencies are and completely ignoring the anti and output dependencies. Why? Well, because the renaming would eliminate them anyway. All that would be left is the true dependencies. So you actually, when you're computing the LP, don't really need to look at a renamed program. You can do it directly on the program as it was written. You just need to follow only the true dependencies and completely ignore the anti and output dependencies. Second, you know, when checking this off, be mindful to kind of remember how many cycles you are computing and also what has been done and so on. And then, you know, just be careful also to kind of divide the right thing with the right thing. So it's 5 instructions over 2 cycles, not the other way around.